Hey, today I want to talk about three lies that we're being told every time we turn on the TV or the internet, see a commercial, or look at a billboard. And these lies are pervasive. They're everywhere. They're throughout our culture. And most everybody believes them too. These three lies have a direct impact on the issue of gay marriage. But not just gay marriage. It also affects teen pregnancy, teen sex, adultery, the divorce rate, pornography, prostitution, even misogyny. First lie, number one, sex is for fun. Now this is not to say that sex isn't fun, or at least can be fun, but that isn't its purpose. It's for enjoyment, for recreation. And I think we all know that that is a common misconception about sex and sexuality. That sexual intercourse is for the sake of enjoyment. It's for a good time. And what's so bad about this lie? Even if we eliminate the possibility of STDs, even if we eliminate the possibility of unplanned pregnancy, sex without love, sex without communion, without intimacy, is destructive to the human psyche. Even if I can convince my head that it's all just for fun, in my heart, there's a longing to be committed to this person. And some people ignore this feeling by simply having sex with many different people as often as possible. But all that does is numb the feeling. It's like hitting yourself enough times, you stop feeling it after a while. But it's still damaging. So that's lie number one. Lie number two contradicts lie number one a bit, but it's still widely believed. Lie number two is this. The only way to have happiness is to have a sexual partner. The flip side of it is to say the only way to have intimacy is to have sex. And that just isn't true. Having sex is not a guarantee for having either intimacy or happiness. There's plenty of people who have lots of sex that aren't happy and don't have intimacy. And it's also very possible to have both happiness and intimacy without having sex. So that's lie number two. Lie number three is on a different tack altogether, but it's still related. This is lie number three. Marriage is a right. It's saying that these people should have the right to get married while those people do not have the right to get married. That whole schema is wrong. Marriage shouldn't be regarded as a right at all. Marriage is a calling. It's a vocation. It's a mission from God, wherein two people show their love for each other and God loves them through each other. Marriage is more than just a legal commitment. It's a sacred covenant. So it's not difficult to see how these, particularly the third lie, affects our perspective on gay marriage, but not just gay marriage. These three lies have had a disastrous effect on our whole culture. We got to identify them as lies and put the word out there so that maybe everyone can see them as lies and instead come to see the truth.